places to the Joe Rogan podcast. For those of you who don't know who Joe Rogan is, go and check him out. And he has, like, not really so much famous people. He does sometimes, but other times it's just normal everyday people on his podcast. And he had on there a Navy pilot who claims to have investigated a UFO sighting, like he's seen himself whilst he was in his jet or whatever the hell you call it, his plane. And he was that detailed in what he said on the interview. I don't see how he could make it up, and why would he? I mean, he's a Navy pilot, a decorated Navy pilot, really high up in the ranks, and his bosses knew about this before he even went up in the sky. They knew they'd seen something. So I'll try and find out his name and drop it in the description box so you can check out the video if you're interested. And I am not very open-minded about anything, whether it be life after death, far for Christmas, the tooth fairy, religion, Man City, spaceships or not, or if that's a bit far-fetched, but there's got to be something out there. So I want to do a little series of videos on aliens and UFOs and all that sort of mumbo jumbo. So in today's video, we're going to take a look at 15 facts about Area 51 that you may not know. Now I will be eating wine gums whilst we do this video because I'm a bit peckish and see how it goes. So, Area 51 is just the sort of bureaucrat. I've got this from an article on livescience.com, and it starts with Area 51 is just the sort of military jargon that sounds like the basis for a vast conspiracy where, after all, where are areas 1 through 50? In fact, the name comes from designations on Nevada test site maps from the 1950s. Area 51 is part of the Nevada test site, not known as the Nevada National now known as the Nevada National Security Site. A remote area of desert 65 miles north of Las Vegas. It was the Nevada test site that hosted hundreds of nuclear weapons tests starting in the 1950s, almost 100 of which were above ground. Now, conspiracies. Actual nuclear tests actually aren't very scary. Area 51's major claim to fame is an alleged extraterrestrial technology research site. It all started in July 1947 when the Roswell Daily Records front page headline screamed, RAAF captures flying saucer on ranch in Roswell region. The US military claimed the unidentified crashing object was just a weather balloon perhaps there was a large-eyed alien or a grey inside. In September 1994, the Air Force released a report with a fuller story. The wreckage was indeed a balloon, but not an ordinary weather balloon. Instead, it was an atomic monitoring balloon meant to detect far-off nuclear testing blasts. That's what they tried to pass it off as. Delayed UFO claims. Despite the headline-making balloon crash in 1947, Area 51 didn't really get its extraterrestrial reputation until the late 1980s. When a man named Robert Lazar told a Las Vegas television station that he worked at a mysterious site called S4 near Area 51 to reverse engineer crashed flying saucers. Now, I've heard Bob Lazar or Robert Lazar on the Joe Rogan podcast, and he is another man who is very, very convincing with what he says. This caused quite a stir. But Lazar was later found to have fabricated his employment, not only on the base, but his entire background. He claims to have graduated from MIT and Caltech, but actually went to neither. And he also claims to have worked for Los Alamos National Laboratory, which also turned out to be false. Now, I don't know if that's just the American government trying to make out like it's a fraud, but he was on the Joe Rogan podcast and Joe seemed to believe everything he was saying. Okay, no visitors. Area 51 is on the map. Good luck actually getting there. It's a restricted area with armed guards patrolling the fences around the perimeter. They're colloquially known as camo dudes because that's what they wear when on the job. Given the testing of stealth aircraft on the site, this kind of secrecy isn't very surprising. However, the guards may be the ones who are most affected by the military silence surrounding the sites. Guards have sought compensation for breathing problems they say they've experienced since being exposed to toxic chemicals from the burning of the coatings meant to shield aircraft from radar. Fuck, sod that. You'll get me working there. Another conspiracy. As if crashed UFOs weren't enough, some theorists also think that Area 51 is where the moon landing was staged. In the 1974 book, We Never Went to the Moon, America's $30 billion swindle, conspiracy theorist Bill Kaysing argues that NASA astronauts never made it to space, and that all the footage of Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin walking on the lunar surface was filmed at Area 51. I believe so. I don't believe they went to the moon. Of course, the moon landing wasn't faked. I think this web page is very much on the government side by the sounds of it. The six Apollo missions even brought back 842 pounds or 382 kilograms of moon rock as souvenirs. Some space equipment like rovers and life support systems were tested in Nevada, a nuclear next Saturday. I'm going to take the dog with me for a little walk on the moon. It should be that simple. 50, 60 years later. But we've not been back. Why? I ask you why. What's the next bit? Air Force affiliation. Officially. Trespassing can result in arrest and up to $1,000 fine, 6 months in prison or both, which human population of 98. And an alien population of ? There's no gas station in Rachel, and the trailer that built itself at the Area 51 Research Center has shut down. But visitors can enjoy a meal at their little alien inn and stay at the conspiracy-focused Dreamland Resort. More mystery. In 2016, Google Earth Images revealed a mysterious mile-long landing strip in Area 6 of the Yucca Flat test site about 12 miles northeast of Area 51. A handful of hangars cluster at one end of the runway. Nothing is known about what exactly is being tested on the airstrip, but the Department of Defense and the Department of Homeland Security both use the site. Security experts told Alive Science that the site might be used to test reconnaissance drones and their sensors. Captured aircraft. There have been no good evidence that the military captured and studied UFOs at Area 51, but files declassified in 2013 revealed that the US did test secretly obtained Soviet MiG fighters during the Cold War of the 70s and 80s. These secretive projects were dubbed Half Donut, Half Drill and Half Ferry. Other secrets. Those same documents were the ones that revealed that Area 51, or Groom Lake for those who prefer the official terminology, was a testing site for the Lockheed A-12 Oxcart and the D-21 Tagboat. They also revealed that the F-117 Nighthawk, a stealth attack aircraft made by Lockheed, was tested at Area 51. The craft started operating in 81 but was kept secret from the public until 88. Nighthawks were flown in the Gulf War and during the war in Yugoslavia, as well as in the Iraq War. Hillary Clinton's promises, this is the last bit, guys. Oh, what could have been during the 2016 race to secure the Democratic nomination for president. Candidate Hillary Clinton said she'd like to make more files about Area 51 public. I'd like us to go into those files and hopefully make as much of that public as possible. If there's nothing there, let's tell people there's nothing there, Clinton told Jimmy Kimmel on Jimmy Kimmel Live in August of that year. Clinton told Kimmel that her husband Bill Clinton had looked for information on government knowledge of extraterrestrials during his presidency and come up with nothing. Yes, okay, so the powers that be, the people who really run America and the world, are gonna let Hillary Clinton, this little tiny woman, come along and reveal all their secrets they've worked so hard to keep, just that, a secret. Don't be stupid. Do I believe we went to the moon? No. Do I believe there are extraterrestrials out there? Yes. Do I believe we really want to go to the moon? Hell no, because you don't know what's waiting for you up there. Anyway, guys, this is part one of a series of videos that I do where we will find some websites that ain't so pro-government, which is what clearly was up the government's arse. I don't like that. So the next time, we'll find one that's a lot more alien-friendly. Okay, thanks for watching. Thumbs up. Subscribe. Comment below. We'll leave the sweets out there.